So now that we have seen what storage devices look like, let's talk about how they and other I/O devices can be connected to the system. We usually connect I/O devices using some sort of a standardized I/O bus. It needs to have a standard because we want to be able to connect, for example, hard drives from one manufacturer to a computer built by another one, and then possibly even replace the hard drive with another one from another manufacturer, or even move our existing hard drive from one system to a new one we are buying so that we can access our data without having to spend a lot of time copying it. Because these buses have standards, they have a limited rate of improvement, and often this improvement goes in steps. So although the technology might go up in a relatively smooth fashion, this is where a new standard gets adopted by manufacturers, this is another one, and so on. Meanwhile, this is where a new standard gets adopted by a manufacturer, so things suddenly improve. But then for a while, you just have the same buses, even though the technology is actually improving. And instead of having just one type of bus that connects to all I/O devices, typically we have a hierarchy of buses. You have a mezzanine bus, such as PCI Express. It will be pretty fast and short so that it can be this fast. And it can be used to directly connect fast devices to the processor, such as, for example, graphics. Then we will connect storage buses to it, for example, the SATA or SCSI for hard drives. Both of these are used usually to connect storage devices. These are somewhat specialized for storage, and a SATA controller will act as a PCI Express device on the mezzanine bus. But the controller itself actually controls a SATA bus to which we now connect devices. So the reason why we have these and don't directly connect our hard drives to the PCI Express is that although these, for example, serial ATA buses are slower, there is also less change in their standards, and there need not be that much change because these devices are much slower than what the PCI Express can provide. So we don't really need all the speed of PCI Express. In exchange, we get to keep our hard drive standards for a while longer, while PCI Express can improve a little bit more rapidly. All we have to do is devise new controllers that connect these storage buses to the newest PCI Express that we have. And then we can have a USB hub, for example, also attached to a PCI Express bus. The USB hub itself provides a USB bus connection for USB devices that are even slower than, for example, SATA. But again, their standard lives for a lot longer, so we can use a lot of different devices relatively cheaply and connect them to this. So overall, what we can have is a PCI Express bus to which we can attach the processor, the graphics, the I/O bus control for disks, for USB, and these in turn provide buses to which we can attach disks here and all sorts of devices here. So the closer we get to the processor, the more important it is to keep improving speeds because some of the devices like graphics need that speed, but for storage and for many of the standard USB devices, we really are much more interested in standardization so that we can exchange these, so that we can interchange these devices and not have them tied to a particular technology and have to change them every year or two.